Hey guys, JK Wargames, and today we're going to do a playthrough of Scenario 1, Into the Countryside, of Scream Aim Fire. So we've got the board set up, the American units on this side, two M4 tanks, and the Germans start with their MG42 in their marked hex, and two Panzer IVs in their marked hex. Game turn marker is on turn 1. Morale is on 0 and German reserve is on 0. So, the first turn, the first part is enemy spotted check. So, if there's 5 or less Germans on the table, we need to roll. So, here we go. We rolled a 4. So, on a 4, we get 4 normal infantry and 3 veterans. So, we're going to choose 4 standard infantry. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 3 veterans, which I'll just get here. 1, 2, 3. So we're going to place these first. Let's start with this guy, placing him in the hex. So we roll a 1, he goes in the center. This next infantry, we roll a 3, so he goes in number 3. This guy, we roll a 5. So he goes in the 5th hex, which is there. This guy here, he rolls a 1. So he can go in that center, because you can stack up to a limit of 2. And then we've got 3 veterans coming in. So we roll for the first veteran. He rolls a 6. So a 6 places him there. This veteran, he rolls a 6, which would place him there. And this last guy rolls a 1. We can't place him in there. So if the X is available, he goes in the X. So that's the enemy spotted check. We're now going into our order phase. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 Germans. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 Americans. So we're not outnumbered. If we were outnumbered, we could roll 6 order dice. But we're only getting to roll 5. So, first order phase for the Americans. Okay, not great, but not too bad. So, these two ones are going to be no use because we can attach a medic or we can assault. So, we don't need to do it at the moment. So, these are wasted. But I can change one dice. So, I will actually change this to a 2. So we've got 4 twos, so we can move or fire with these. So this is a good opportunity to move our troops up. So with this 2, we're going to move the veterans and the first lieutenant. They're going to move up. So where are they going to go? They're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. So that costs them 1, 2, 3, 4, because it costs 2 movement points to go into a woods. So they're done. The next veteran here, he's going to move as well. So he's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, like so. And then we can move 2 more infantry. So let's get these guys moving. So this infantry unit here are going to move 1, 2, 3, 4. Go next to those vets. And we've got one more order, and we're going to issue an order to this infantry up here. And they're going to go 1, 2, 3. We can't get in there, so they're actually going to go just into the woods. So they're going to go 1, 2, 3, like that. That's all the orders we can issue this turn, so it's not too bad. We managed to move them up a bit, but we haven't been able to move our tanks. It's not turn 3, so we don't roll for reserves. There's been no firing, so we're going into the German step, or German phase. So, adjustment phase. There is nothing to adjust, no one's panicked. So we go into infantry actions, and they're all calm at the moment. So we're going to start with this unit here, and we're going to draw an action card. Looking at the calm section, no action for that unit. This veteran unit here, no action for them as well. The unit underneath, which is another veteran unit, move two hexes, change to alert. So let's check his ID. His ID is 2. So he is going to be going towards unit 2. And unit 2 is this American unit here. So he's moving two hexes towards, trying to use cover, but there is no cover here. So he's just going to go 1, 2, and then change to alert. So he changed to alert. Okay, this veteran up here, move up to two hexes, change to alert. Now he's got a 6 on him. I don't believe there's a 6 on the board, there's not. So he's gonna go towards the closest unit. And the closest unit for him is gonna be this infantry and mortar. So he's going 2 hexes this way, 1, 2. So he ends in this hex and he changes to alert. So both those veteran units have pushed up and now they're alert. First infantry unit in the center hex. Let's draw a card for them. Move one hex, move up to one hex, fire from range, change to alert if unit fired. So he's got a 9 on him. We don't have a unit with a 9 on. So again, it's gonna be the closest unit. So he's coming towards these guys here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so they're coming towards the first lieutenant and the veteran unit. So he goes, only goes one hex though. So he's gonna end up in that hex stacked like that. And he hasn't fired, so he doesn't change to alert. The next unit in the center, Akam, same thing, move up to one hex. So do we have a 10 on the board? That's a 12, 11, nope. So he's gonna be moving towards these. So one hex, he can't go in this hex because there's already two units in that hex. So he's moving one hex into there. And the last infantry unit, we're gonna draw a card for them. They are calm and it's no action. So next we move on to the MG42 team. Now they have a range of 6. Line of sight is blocked here. So they can't fire through here because the woods are blocking line of sight. They can't fire at the first lieutenant and the veterans because the building's blocking line of sight. They do have line of sight up to this infantry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they're going to fire at this infantry. They have a 4+ on them, but they're in woods, so it's now 5+. MG42s roll 2 dice and pick the highest. And they miss, and 2 and a 1, so that's lucky for us. Okay, onto the German tanks. Now, if they're in range, they will fire. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just out of range. So he just moves one hex towards the closest tank. And it's gonna be the same for this tank. He's not in range, so he just moves one hex towards him. The last part of the German step is to check for a surprise unit. So on a 6, we will get a German surprise unit. We roll a 3, so we don't get a unit. We go to turn 2. So, enemy spotted check. There are definitely more than 5 units on the board, so we don't need to do that. So we're going straight into the order phase. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's our 5 dice. And that is not bad at all. So we've got a 6, a 5, a 4, a 3 and a 1. Okay, not bad at all. So I'm going to change this 6 into a 4. No, I can't do that. Okay, so I'm actually going to change that into a 5. So we can activate both our tanks. So let's activate our first tank, this guy here. He's got a range of 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he's gonna fire at the Panzer IV. So I'm drawing a fire chip from here. And the result is a hit. So we've hit that German tank. Now we're going to draw a damage counter to see what effect we've had on the Panzer IV. I draw it, and it's bounced. So he bounced the shot. So that's annoying. So he lives to fight another day. Okay, let's activate our other tank, which is up here. Now he hasn't got range. He has a range of 5, and he can fire HE at infantry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's not in range. So he's going to move 2, 1, 2 to there. So that's both our tanks activated. Okay, so the single 4 we're not going to be able to use because we need 2 4s to activate a mortar. The 3 we're going to be able to move and fire, and the 1 we can't attach a medic, so it actually isn't as good as I thought. So the 3 we're going to move and fire. So what we're actually going to do is move into this building with the veterans and the first lieutenant. That costs 3 movement points. Remember, we have 4, and they're now in range. 1, 2, 3. So they're going to fire at these guys. They are veterans in a clear hex. So we're going to draw a cover card and look at the clear hex part. And they've got no extra cover. So it's just a 5+. Now, we get a +1 for being veterans and a +1 for having our first lieutenant attached. So we've got a +2 on this die roll. We roll a 3, +2 is 5. They are eliminated. So that's good. So they're eliminated. And we draw a chip to see what effect it's had on morale. So drawing, and it is destroyed +5. So the morale score moves up to 5. And to win this objective, we need 40 morale and we need to capture the objective hex. So that was pretty good. And that's the American turn done. It's still not turn 3, so we don't roll for reserves yet. So it's into the German phase, and there are no adjustments, no one's panicked. So we go into drawing action cards. So we start with this guy who is alert, and he is going to hit the dirt, fire at +1 on die roll, or move up to 1 hex, fire if in range. So what's his ID? 6. Is he going for a 6? No. So he's going for the closest unit, which is this unit here. So he's going to move 1 hex and fire if in range. 1, 2, 3. He's definitely in range now. Now the veterans are in a building, so they've got +2. So they're on a 5, 6, 7. And veterans get a +1. So they need to roll a 6, but a natural six is a hit anyway. So they need a 6 to hit the veterans. Oh my goodness, they rolled a 5. So no effect. However, the first lieutenant is attached to this squad. We need to roll a dice. On a result of 1, the lieutenant is killed. And he is not killed. He's fine. However, this action card has this icon. So that German unit goes low on ammo. So they cannot fire next turn. Okay, next unit will do this unit here, and they are calm. So they're going to move up to 1 hex and fire if in range. So they have a 10 on them, so they're going for the closest unit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They're veterans and they're veterans. So I'm going to say the closest one, and in terms of line of sight, is this unit here. So they're going to move 1 hex. Oh, nearly. They're going to move 1 hex to here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. They're not in range to fire. And they would have changed to alert if the unit fired, but they didn't. Okay, I've just reshuffled the action deck. Okay, so next unit be this unit with an 11 on them. They are calm and they get no action. this infantry unit here. Move up to 2 hexes, change to alert because they're calm. And they've got a 9 on them. We'll just double check there's no 9 on the board. There isn't. And the closest unit is here. So they're moving 2 hexes. So they go 1, 2. So they're going to be in that hex. And they change to alert. They don't fire, but they change to alert. This infantry unit here, who was stacked with them, they're calm. So they have the same thing, move up to 2 hexes, change to alert. And they've got an 8. Now 8 are down here, 8 are on the board. So they're coming down this way, 2 hexes. So they were, where were they? Were they here or here? Can't remember, I think they were here. So they're going 1, 2. And they're gonna change to alert as well. Okay, and the last infantry in this hex, they are calm, so we draw a card. Move up to 2 hexes and change to alert. So they're going for unit 4, and unit 4 on the board, they're over here. So they're gonna go 1, 2, and then change to alert. We now go to the MG42 phase, and the MG42, does he have line of sight? From his hex here, to this hex, line of sight is traced from the center. So the center of that hex is there. So he does have line of sight to them because it doesn't, the line doesn't go through the building. If it went like this, then it'd be blocked, but he has line of sight. So he's gonna open fire on the unit with the first lieutenant. Remember they're in a building. So there are 5, 6, 7. So they need a 6. But they've rolled 2 dice and picked the highest. Nope, they've missed. There is a first lieutenant attached. Let's see what happens. He's fine on a 3. Remember, a 1 would kill him. So now we go to tanks. This Panzer IV is in range. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he's going to fire at our tank. So let's draw a chit. And the result is a miss. We'll take that all day. And the next German tank does have line of sight, but he's not in range. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he's gonna move 1 closer to us. So that's better for us next turn. We're gonna roll to see if we get a German surprise unit. And we do. So on a 1 to 3, it will be a AT gun. On a 4, 5, 6, it will be a veteran unit. It's a veteran unit. So the veteran unit comes in via the blue hex, but we have a unit in the blue hex. So it comes in next to the blue hex like this. Okay, and their job is they're gonna move 2 hexes each turn towards the first lieutenant, but hopefully we'll take them out before they can get there. Okay, so on to turn 3. So enemy spotted check. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we're fine. And we're not outnumbered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, no, no way. Okay, so 5 dice, 5 ordered dice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's try and get some good orders. Okay, not bad. That's not bad. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're going to change this 6 into a 5. And the first 5 we're going to use with our tank. He's going to fire at the Panzer IV. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Definitely in line of sight. In range, sorry. So he's going to draw a token. And the result is a hit. And then we're going to see what the effect is. Here we go. And the effect is... bounced again. Oh my goodness, how annoying. So tough armor on these Panzer IVs. We're going to use this 5 to fire at this Panzer IV. So let's draw a chit again, and the result is a hit. Can we get a good result this time? Bailout, 5 morale. So he is destroyed and we get 5 morale, so we're up to 10 morale. so that's not too bad. And we've destroyed two German units, so we receive a supply marker, which we can use later. Okay, so that's our tanks. The single four, we're not gonna be able to use, but we've got a three and a two. So, with the two, we're gonna fire with the first lieutenant and the veterans. And they're gonna fire on this unit here. And they are infantry in a clear hex. So we're gonna draw a cover card. They've got no cover, so it's just a four plus. And remember, we get a plus two to our dice roll because we are veterans and we've got a first lieutenant attached. We roll a five, we've eliminated them. Brilliant. So that German unit is destroyed and we're going to draw a chip to see the result. And the result is, oh yes, destroyed plus 10. So we get 10 morale. So we're on 10, we go up to 20. We're halfway there on morale score. Okay, and then we've got a three, which is a move and fire. So we're going to move this veteran unit here, are gonna go one, and then into the building for three. So that's four movement points. He can now draw line of sight to the MG42 team. He's drawing line of sight along the line of this hex here, from the center of his hex along this line. So he has got line of sight into the woods. This doesn't block it. So he's gonna fire. Now the MG42 team are in cover, so we need to draw a cover card and look at the cover part, hard cover plus two. So this is gonna be difficult. We need a five, six, seven. We get a plus one, and remember, a six always hits. So we need a six to hit this guy, and we get a plus one. So that's a five, plus one takes it to a six, but we actually needed a seven. If we'd rolled a six, a natural six is always a hit. We missed. Okay, and that's the German turn, American turn, but it is turn three. So on a roll of a six, we get reserves. Nope, it's a five. So, German phase, adjustment phase. Now, this unit here, remove this marker in the next turn. So it's not as, some people are getting confused by this, you don't remove this straight away. In the rule book, it says removed unless units panicked. You actually remove this a turn later. So effectively this marker means this unit can't fire for one turn. So we don't need to adjust that. No one else is panicked. So this unit we're gonna draw for, because they can still move, they're just out of ammo. So they are alert under there and they would fire if they're in range. They're gonna move up to two hexes and assault if possible. So this is interesting. They've got a six on them. And do we have a six on the board? No. So they're moving up to two hexes. So they're going one, two. Then assault if possible. Well, they are going to assault because a unit can assault if they are in an adjacent hex. They don't have to get into the hex. They move into the hex after the assault. So, the Germans are assaulting. They're low on ammo. So they're gonna have some modifiers for that. So, they're gonna roll 4d6, but we got modifiers. And the modifiers are, they are in a building. So there's gonna be a minus two on their die roll. And what else? So minus two and that's it. Yeah, so if we were attacking, we would get a plus one for them being low on supply. So we've actually got minus two on this dice roll and they need 14 to be successful. And they've scored 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, minus two. They were not successful. They remain in that hex, low on supply. Okay, So we'll go for this unit here, who are alert. Fire if in range, move up to 2 hexes, assault if possible. Now, they have a unit there, but let's check their ID. Their ID is 8. So they are moving down here. They're moving 2 hexes, but while they move, they become adjacent to this unit. And they will open fire on this unit. So, without confusing anyone, so basically they're going for unit 8, so they couldn't fire if they're in range, but they've not moved up to 2 hexes. They managed to move, but as soon as they become adjacent, they will fire on a unit. So, they're going to fire. The veterans are in a building, so they're going to need a 6 to hit, basically. And they are veterans, so they get a +1. Nope, they've missed. So that was lucky. This infantry here, we draw an action card. And they are calm, so they get no action. This infantry unit next to them, they are calm, no action. This unit's alert. And they're going to fire if they're in range. They're not in range and they've got 4 on them. So 4 are here. So they're going to move up to 2 hexes. 1, 2. And they would assault if possible, but they can't. They're not in range too. So that concludes the infantry. So now we go to the MG42. The MG42 cannot fire on anyone. These guys have blocked their line of sight now. They wouldn't fire into their own guys. So that kind of helps us. That's quite handy. So the AI have mucked up there. So we're going to go to German tanks. And we've got this guy here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he is going to fire at that tank. So we're going to draw chit. And the result is, oh, 2 crosshair icons, so that means we need to use our side armor, not our front armor. So basically we need a 6 to save. Oh my goodness, we saved it, so we don't need to draw a damage counter. Oh my goodness, that's good. So, and the surprise unit here are going to move 2 hexes towards the first lieutenant. They totally ignore these guys, so they're going to go 1, 2. Like this. They don't fire at these because they're adjacent. They're a surprise unit, got a special mission to get to the first lieutenant. Okay, and while a surprise unit is in play, you don't roll for another one. There's only one surprise unit in play. So we're going to go to turn 4. So enemy spotted check. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're still fine. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So yeah, we're fine. So we're gonna roll our order dice. Let's see what happens. Okay, interesting. That's actually worked out quite well. So let's go with the 2 ones. 2 ones means we can assault a unit in an adjacent hex. These guys are adjacent, and these guys are adjacent. They're both veterans, so I kind of want to keep him there because he's blocking the MG42. So we're going to assault here with the first lieutenant. Okay, so we get 4d6. So let's remember that's a 3. We get 4d6 with some modifiers. So the modifiers are, we get a +1. Because we got first lieutenant attached, and we get another +1 because they're low on supply. So we've got a +2 to this roll. We've killed them. They're eliminated. Brilliant. And we gain 10 morale from an assault. So assaults are powerful. So we go up to 30. So this is looking good. Okay, we need to change one of those back to a 3. And that was good. Okay, so let's use the 5 to fire our tank. We've got a bit of a standoff going on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're going to draw see if we can get a hit on him. And the result is a hit. So two icons don't mean anything when firing at a German tank because they don't have saves. So we're going to draw a damage counter. Come on, we've got to destroy this guy, surely. And he's bounced it. God, that tank. He's bounced it again, so we can't get him. Okay, and then we've got two move and fires. Also, in the assault, we could move into that hex if we wanted to, but I'm not going to move in there. I'd rather stay in the building. Okay, so this unit are going to fire. Now, because it's a move and fire, you don't have to do both. You can use that three to move or fire. So he's going to fire on this unit here. So he is a veteran in a clear hex. Yeah, so veteran in clear hex. So looking at the clear hex part, he's got light cover plus one. So we now need a six. And he is a veteran, so he gets a plus one to his die roll. Four plus one is five. We've missed. No good. And we've got one more unit. One, two, three, four. Yes. So these guys are going to move. Infantry. They're going to go one, two, three, four into the woods. Become adjacent to these guys. They're going to go for the MG42 team. So he's in a cover hex. So we've got a bunker, no fire. So that's wasted. We can't fire at them. They've obviously, that MG42 team managed to find a bunker and we can't fire at them. So that's the end of our turn. Let's see if we get a reserve unit. And we don't. So we are going on to German phase. So the Germans, no one's panicked because they're not within two. And no one's got a low supply anymore. So let's start with this alert unit here. So drawing an action card. They're going to assault if unit is in range. God, there's lots of assaults going on here. Now, he's going for eight. So the eight is adjacent to him. So they're assaulting there. So it's nice and easy. So they're rolling 4d6. One, two, three, four. This unit are in woods, so we should have a bit of cover. So let's have a look. So woods is a minus one. So there's a minus one on their roll. And we've actually, yeah, no, it's a minus one. So 4d6 with a minus one. So they get 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, minus one is 14. They've actually destroyed this unit, and in assaults you're just killed outright, and we lose 10 morale, so our morale of 30 goes back down to 20. Oh, that's frustrating. And then they take that hex, so they now move into that wood hex, and they've opened the way for the MG42 team. So this is disaster. Oh no, that's not good. So we'll go to this alert unit here. Fire if in range. Now, what's their ID? ID is four. I think we do have a four on the board. We do, they're there. So they're not in range to fire at him. So he's gonna move up to two hexes towards them. So he's going one, two, and then he would assault if possible. He can't, so that's his action done. We're gonna go for this standard infantry here. They are calm. Move up to two hexes, change to alert. So they're going for 10. I don't believe there's a 10 on the board. So they're going for the closest unit, which are the veterans here. So they can't move two. They move one towards him and they change to alert. So now the MG42 is blocked. So that's brilliant work from the AI. Okay, so that's him. And then this guy. Move up to two hexes, change to alert. So we do have 11, which is this guy. So he's gonna go one, two, and stack in the hex with this guy. And he changes to alert. So we'll put an alert counter on him. And then they're both in that hex. The MG42 can't fire, and now the Panzer IV is going to fire our tank. Infantry do not block fire when you fire when tanks are firing at tanks. They don't block the way. If you imagine this gun is firing, the infantry would be laying down flat on the ground, taking cover while this tank is firing. So he's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's in range. He's going to take a shot at our tank, and the result is a hit. So it's only one crosshair, so we need a 5+ to save our tank. And we've done it. This is like, this whole game has been a massive standoff between these two tanks. So that was good. So that's the end. We haven't moved this guy. He's going to move two towards the first lieutenant. So we really need to take care of him. Okay, so we're going to turn 5. And enemy spotted check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so we don't need to roll that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we go. Okay, not too bad. We haven't been able to activate our mortars this game, which is really frustrating because they're very, very powerful in screen main fire. So we don't need to use the 1, so I'm actually going to change that into a 2, like so. Okay, and with the 2, this veteran unit are going to fire at the infantry in a clear hex. So this top infantry here, we're firing at them. They're in a clear hex. Let's see what we get. They've got light cover +1, so we need a 5 to hit them. And we get a +1, remember, because we're veterans. And they are destroyed. Beautiful. So they're gone. That's another supply marker. So we've got 2 supply markers now. And let's see what happens to our morale. Destroyed +5. So we go up to 25. Okay, so that was good. Now with the 3, see, it's tempting to get onto the objective, but we need to wait really until we've got the correct morale. So with the 3, the first lieutenant, they're going to fire from this building at these guys in the open. They're standard infantry, so they're in a clear hex and they get +1 cover, so 5. Remember, veterans +1, first lieutenant +1, so we've got +2. 5, 6, 7, they're destroyed. So this is great. This is really good. So let's see the result. And the result is destroyed +10. Beautiful. So we go from there to 35. 5 more morale to get to 40. This has been a good turn. Now I've got 2 5s. He's going to fire back at this tank. Surely we can finish this tank off. So let's see what we get. Oh, we've destroyed him outright. So if you get a crosshair icon with a red background like that, it destroys him outright and you gain 5 morale. So it's actually perfect. So he's destroyed. That's another supply counter. And we've got 40 morale points. Okay, so that was one tank. Our other tank is going to open with HE fire onto this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4. And he's in a clear hex. So we do draw a cover card and we use the clear hex part of the card. So he's got +1 cover. So he's a 6. But we get to roll 2 dice and choose the highest. So we didn't hit him. We got a 5. So nope, we didn't get him. And the single 6, we could do covering fire. But we're not going to be able to do that. So that's the end of the American turn. Do we get reserves? Nope. German phase. Let's go with this guy. He's alert. Assault if unit is in range. So he is going to assault because unit 8 are not on the board anymore, and this is the closest unit. So they're doing an assault on these guys. And they're in a building, so it's going to be a minus 2 on their dice roll. So minus 2. So we got 10. Oh dear. Yep, they've been destroyed. So we lose 10 morale, so our 35 goes back. Our 40 goes back to 30. And that's how frustrating it can get. And actually, we should have been moving this. Come on, Jay, you're the designer. I should have been moving this German reserve. This is now on 10. Oh, man, that was not good. Okay, we'll go for this alert unit now. And they actually take that hex then, these guys. So these Germans are in a building right next to the objective. Great. This alert unit. Hit the dirt, fire plus 1 on die roll. Who are they going for? They're going for 11. Nope. 11 are not on the board, so this is the closest unit. So they are 1, 2, 3. Definitely in range, but they're in a building. So there's a plus 2. And they are standard infantry. So, but they get a plus 1 because the action card has told us. So they need a 5, 6, 7. So they need a 6, basically. Oh my God, I can't believe it. That's typical. So that unit changes to alert. So they've been hit and changed to alert. What happens to the first lieutenant? He's fine. He wasn't hit. Oh my goodness. MG42 can't fire because he's not in range. This guy now moves 2 hexes. 1, 2. And that is the end of the German turn. We don't roll for a surprise unit because they're still in play. So we go to turn 6. Enemy spotted check. So the Germans now have 1, 2, 3, 4 units. So we do roll on the table. And we roll a 3. So that is 3 standard infantry. Bring them in. So we've got 1, 2, 3, and 2 veterans. So we'll draw 2 veterans from the cup. Okay, just when we look like we were about to get victory, things are starting to fall apart. So let's place these guys. So we'll start with this infantry here. Number 2, so he goes in hex 2 there. This guy, a 5. So he goes in hex 5. This guy rolls a 3. So he goes in hex 3. This veteran rolls a 1. So he goes in the center. And this last veteran rolls a 5. So he goes in hex 5 here. Okay, so they now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can roll 6 dice on our orders now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this should help us. And that's an optional rule called We're Surrounded. So here we go. Okay. Not the greatest roll. But let's see. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The tank's going to open up with HE fire at these guys. They are in cover, but because we're firing HE with the tank, we use the clear part, and they've got no cover. So it's just a straight up 5 plus, and we get to roll 2 dice. So I need to remember to bring this dice back. And we need a 5. Ah, no, we missed him. Okay, and replace one of those with a 5. The other 5 we're going to use here. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he's not in range for that. And he can't. You can fire your main cannon through your own infantry, but not a machine gun. Plus they're in a building, so that's blocked. So this guy's just going to move 2 hexes out like this. Okay. So that's him done. First Lieutenant. And the unit he is with, are going to have to move because this guy is going to gain on this turn unless we can fire at him and remove him. This is very dodgy. Let's think about this. Yep, they're going to move. So they're going to go 1, 2, which is a very dangerous move, but we're going to go for it. So they're on the objective hex. 1, 2. This guy's going to move. He's going to go 1, 2. Three, four, to there. Okay. And then, with these two dice, we could assault, but this unit's already acted. You can't use a unit twice. So, yes, that is not a great turn. Not gonna lie. Okay. So, this guy moves twice, 1, 2. Now he doesn't capture attempt to capture the first lieutenant yet. He actually has to get in the same hex. It's different to an assault. So we'll start with this infantry here. He's calm. Move up to one hex, fire if in range. So he's going for unit 4, which are there. So he's going to go 1, 2. He doesn't fire. This guy is going for the closest, so, and he gets no action because he's calm. Center hex, veterans, move up to one hex, fire if in range. Now I'm pretty sure this is unit 12. Yes, it is. So they go there, one hex, 1, 2, 3. He does have line of sight through to them. So he's firing at them. They're gonna need a 5, and they are a veteran unit, so they get a +1. Nope, that would be a 4, but they do change to alert because they fired. Oh, okay, just reshuffle the action card deck. And we got 2 more infantry to activate. We just need 10 morale. If we can stay in that objective hex, we win. Okay, so this infantry here, move up to one hex, fire if in range. He's going for 11, they're not on the board. This is the closest unit, so he moves here. And the last unit to activate, they get no action, so that's good. No surprise unit, so we go into turn 7. So, we are still outnumbered, so we're going to get to roll 6 dice. And let's have a look at what we can do here. So this is turn 7. That's not a good roll. That's not a good roll. Oh no. Okay. Okay, this isn't too bad. How far away is he? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yeah. So we're going to change this 6 into a 5. Like that. Okay. So, we can assault a unit here. And we are going to... Now, what you have to remember is, if you're adjacent, you can assault a unit with the 2 ones. If you win the assault, you can take ground into that hex if you wish. You don't have to. So we could eliminate an assault. Or, I don't know, let's start with tanks anyway. So this tank is firing HE at these guys. We use the clear hex part of the card. So let's have a look. No cover. So we need a 4+ to hit these guys. And we get them. they are destroyed. Let's have a look at our things. Here we are. Destroy plus 10. We get 40 morale. We're in the objective hex. We have just secured victory. Oh my goodness. So turn 7, we secured victory. Now, you don't have to play the rest of the turn. As soon as you meet victory conditions, you've won. And we have reached 40 morale and we are in the objective hex. So we've just won the first scenario in Scream Aim Fire. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope you can see how tense and fun the game is. Any questions, make sure to comment, like, and subscribe to my channel. That was really good fun. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for all the support, and I'll see you in the next video.